Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, we're going to cover creating Optuma workbooks and how you can save your charts and analysis. So I'm going to open up a list of the 20 symbols. So from the welcome screen, I'm just going to double click, and that will automatically bring up this window, the security selection window. And under ASX shares, I'm going to expand that exchange, and then the S&P folder, and then top 20, and I'm just gonna open list as chart all. And as you can see, we've got 20 tabs across the top now for all of those ticker symbols. And we can move from one to the next just by clicking the tab using the right arrow key on your keyboard, or left to go backwards and forwards. Those directional arrows, you can use that as well, but if you click and hold, you get a list of all those ticker symbols or tabs, and we can click on that to go to the one that we need. What we can also do with these tabs is click and drag and reorder them. So just click and drag with your mouse and drop them there. We also have a lot of options by right-clicking on them. You can change the tab color. So you can, ones that you're maybe watching, you can turn green, or have a position in, you can turn green. You can add an icon from any one of those available there. You can also change the name of the tab. So you can have multiple ticker symbols, or one ticker symbol open on multiple tabs, but to differentiate, we can call this one WPL Daily, for example. And I'm going to put some tools on here. I'm just going to right click and put on a moving average, and then go back and right clicking on that WPL tab. And I'm going to go down to actions here, and you can see clone page. What that's going to do when I select that, it's copied WPL and it's added it to the end of the tabs there. But this time I'm going to change the time frame. So in the chart header here where it says Woodside Petroleum 1 day, we can click on that time frame and change it. So I'm going to change this one to weekly, and as you can see, the moving average is obviously updated. It's now based on a weekly time frame. But what we're going to have to do now is change WPL Daily to weekly. So I can right click, or I can just double click on that tab and then change it to weekly. And I can get the daily one and move it next to the weekly one as well. Going back to the timeframes, because I've only got end of day data on this account at the moment, that's why I can't go intraday. But if you did have a real time data provider that has been configured into Optuma, such as Bloomberg, IQ Feed, or eSignal, then you would see a intraday options in this drop down as well. We can also customize, going back to timeframes. So we can click on customized timeframes, and let's say I want to create a quarterly chart. So I'm going to change that to 3, and then the time period from tick to month, and then I'm going to add that and click OK. And now this is a 3-month chart of WPL, and that's been saved in our list of timeframes. So you can create any custom timeframe you want as well. I'm going to put this one back to daily. Some other workbook features that we have, again, right click on the tab that you're interested in, and what you can do is copy this page to another workbook. So this is particularly useful if you want to just save this off somewhere else. So when we click copy page to workbook, this option pops up. You can select a workbook that's already been saved. I've got one there called Watch. Or you can create a new one, just type a new name and it will create a new workbook. So I'm going to save that into my other workbook there that I've called Watch. And it hasn't moved it, it's just made a copy of it. So all the tools and notes and indicators and everything that you have on this chart has now been copied into that other workbook. So let's say I want to keep this for to come back to next time. We can go click on the File menu button and Save Workbook. And then this window pops up and we can just give it a name. I'm just going to call it My Workbook. And hit Save. And now we can File, Close Workbook. And what you'll notice here, back at the welcome screen, is on the left-hand side. Now we've saved that, it appears in the list of my recent workbooks. So the more workbooks you have and the more you save, you build up a list down here with the most recent one at the top. And you can either open by going to File, Open Workbook, or simply just click on that and it will open at exactly the same spot where it was saved, so WPL Daily. I'm going to close this again so I can go to File, Close Workbook, and I'm going to open my Watch Workbook. So File, Open Workbook. Now all your workbooks are stored locally on your C drive by default. It is possible to save them in the cloud, such as Google Drive or Dropbox or something like that. And we'll talk about that in a later video where we cover the settings. We have a file location settings option that will allow you to put your work safely and securely in the cloud should anything happen, or to back up your work or to share with other people as well. But by default, everything is saved on your C drive in the Documents Optuma folder. But there's Watch, so I'm just gonna double click that. So this is a chart I already had, Woolworths with a couple of tools and indicators. And here's WPL Daily, which is the one I copied in that earlier example. A couple of questions that we regularly get regarding workbooks is the number of charts you can have within a workbook. There really is no limit. It's just a, depending on your system, how many charts it can handle. So you can have hundreds of tabs in a workbook. It just might be a bit more difficult to handle. Another one is, how do I delete workbooks or charts from a workbook? So in this example of, I'll go back to the WPL Daily. We just mouse over the tab there, see, we get the little red cross, and we just click that, and then we get a prompt there. Do I really want to close that page? And then I'll click yes, and that disappears. Going back to the, let's close this. Because I've made a change since the last time it was saved, I get this pop-up. This workbook has changed. Do you want to save it? If I click yes, then that WPL workbook will be gone forever. If I click discard, then that change won't be saved. And so when I reopen this workbook, that will still be there. But I'm going to save it. And now you can see I've got two workbooks in the most recent. So to delete the workbooks, when we mouse over in that list on the left-hand side there, you'll see there's a couple of icons there. There's a little red cross, the small red cross when you mouse over, that will just remove the workbook from the list, so it won't actually delete the workbook from your system. For that, use the trash can underneath. So that will permanently delete the workbook from your C drive. So only do that, obviously, if you want to get rid of your workbook completely. So again, you'll be prompted, so you shouldn't be do that by mistake. So you will get alerted when you click that icon. So hope that's been useful. Any questions, as always, please let us know.